On today's episode, Boeing says no new airliners this decade. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. If you're an airline looking to add serious capacity, you have relatively few airframe options. There was a time when the American aerospace industry alone had civil airframe offerings from companies like Boeing, Douglas, Lockheed, Convair, Martin, and Fairchild. Europe had several major airframers as well, and even the Russians sold into the market with Ilyushin and Tupolev large jets. Today, the market has been distilled down to two major airframers, Airbus and Boeing. Normally, that would be the road toward oligopoly, but the two companies are surprisingly competitive and both enjoy a large order book backlog despite COVID. Both Boeing and Airbus offer a range of airliner products from short-range metro haulers to large transcontinental jets, and both offer freighter versions of those passenger jets. Airbus has a continuous history of new product development, but Boeing Company's CEO David Calhoun, speaking at the firm's annual investor conference last week, stated that the next clean sheet Boeing commercial airliner will not be introduced until the middle of the next decade. This announcement has surprised many analysts who have expected that a new mid-sized aircraft designed to fill the gap left by the Boeing 757 and 767 twin jets would become the 797, leveraging 787 Dreamliner technology in a fuel-efficient package. And fuel efficiency is the key, as Calhoun noted that customers will demand 20 to 30% cost savings over existing aircraft, only a part of which can be delivered by lightweight composites and improved aerodynamics. New engines will be needed, engines which don't currently exist. The CEO also noted that increasingly stringent emissions tests may also be a pacing factor in new power plant and new airframe development. Instead, Boeing will continue to iterate the 737 family and develop the newest versions of the 787 Dreamliner and the 777, which is expected to win a considerable share of the replacement market for four-engine heavyweights, mainly the Airbus A380 and Boeing's own 747. But the real battle in commercial aviation is in narrow bodies. Boeing's order book is backlogged to the tune of just over 5,000 aircraft, of which 80% are 737 models. Airbus has a reported backlog of over 7,000 jets, of which over 90% are A220 and A320 models. Depending on production rate, both companies have 6 to 10 years of aircraft production booked right now without taking on a single additional order. Boeing anticipates that by 2050, global air travel will carry more than 10 billion passengers per year, generate $9 trillion in economic activity, and support 180 million jobs worldwide. Producing enough airframes to satisfy that demand will require new airplanes and new production capability at major airframers, including the addition of China's COMAC, who have officially launched their C919 airliner with some 300 recently announced orders. But engines are key. If they're available, economical, and environmentally friendly, the commercial airplane industry is going to be healthy for decades. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future and Designing the Future, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.